Muy buenos días, muy buenas tardes, depende de donde nos estés viendo. Una vez más en Vivir Evolucionando, en el cable que llega a Colombia, a México, buenos días Paraguay, buenas tardes Chile, en Perú, también se están sumando desde España. Es grande que estamos en la televisión para ti, en este programa que te aporta soluciones, amor, que te aporta felicidad y que te aporta conocimiento de las cosas más insólitas y más antiguas que mucha gente no tiene ni idea de que existen. En el programa de hoy vamos a hablar de la Ayurveda. La Ayurveda, Ayur significa conocimiento y Veda significa vida, el conocimiento de la vida. Esta civilización milenaria que existió entre 15 y 40.000 años atrás y que tenía conocimiento de la astrofísica, de la astrología, conocimiento de la medicina, de la matemática, conocimiento de la botánica, de la salud, de todo. El arte de vivir está, de alguna forma, reviviendo parte de estas ciencias milenarias que quedaron un poco como quedó el latín y como quedó el griego, que quedaron así como lenguas muertas y conocimientos de la antigüedad que quedaron muertos. El trabajo que está haciendo Shri Shri Ravi Shankar, el fundador del arte de vivir, para revivir el Ayurveda es grande. Y hoy tenemos a un representante del arte de vivir que ha venido directamente de la India al estudio, está girando por toda América Latina, está siendo reconocido por intendentes y por gobernadores, por jefes de gobierno, reconocido como visitante ilustre y reconocido por su sabiduría, no solo en la ciencia védica, sino en la meditación. Es un coordinador internacional de los programas del arte de vivir. Swami Parantech estará con nosotros hoy en el estudio y nos va a traer explicaciones sobre esto de la Ayurveda. ¿Qué hay en la medicina Ayurveda? ¿Qué hay en la cosmética de hoy Ayurveda? ¿Y cómo nosotros podemos utilizar esta ciencia? Va a ser un programa espectacular. No te vayas, que volvemos después de la pausa y con todo este conocimiento que va a ser maravilloso. Y ya estamos aquí en el estudio con Swami Parantech, que tiene un nombre raro, se viste raro, tiene el pelo raro, pero es tan especial, tan dulce y sobre todo tan profundo. Swamiji, welcome, very, very welcome to our program. You're being watched all over Latin America. It's wonderful to have you here.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much to all the viewers. For all over the Latin America.
Tell me, you are touring Latin America, how many countries, how many months?
Well, this particular tour, it's about 18 countries and nearly a year.
Nearly a year, for you. For an Indian to be without Indian food, for an Indian to be without Indian weather, for an Indian to be without Indian music, must be very hard.
Not really, because I see that you get everything here, like, you know, food is very easy. You know, it's basic, simple food, which is so easy to cook. So you just tell people and people start doing it. So I'm getting Indian food.
Very good.
And in YouTube and everything, Indian music is also very available. But the only thing is I really miss the physical presence of our master.
Oh, Shri Shri Ravi Shankar. Shankar. Yes. I often speak about him in the program. So we will, every program, you know, Swamiji, ends with the knowledge of Shri Shri Ravi Shankar. We have 3 or 4 minutes to give to the viewers the knowledge of the Shri Shri Ravi Shankar.
You know, it's so nice to have, you know, some enlightened master right being on the planet, and it's the time to fully make use of it.
Take
for
advantage.
Everybody.
That's it. Yes. And today the program, Swamiji, is regarding Ayurveda. Little is known about Ayurveda. I have explained a little bit in the beginning, in the opening of the program, but I would like you to tell the viewers, Ayurveda is a science, is it just a tradition, or how old it is, and what is the influence of the art of living regarding Ayurveda? Medicine, books, astrology, health, whatever.
You know, Ayurveda, as you mentioned, I could make out a little bit, is a science of life.
Mm-hmm.
And if you really look at it, that the whole creation is made up of five elements: earth, air, water, space, and fire. And our body is also made up of these five elements. And if you observe the nature, what happens is, everything, when it's in harmony, you enjoy, it's very pleasant. When it's little disturbed, that's how you become so uncomfortable. So same is the case in us. Like, we have all this, it's a known fact that more than 70% of body has water element. We are breathing air, so we have air element. All the things are moving because of the air element and within the space, and that's how the movement is happening. And we have the temperature maintained, like the fire element, you know, if it goes up, you become fever, you experience fever. And all the solid parts in the body is because of the earth element.
Mm-hmm.
So you are happy, you are enjoying life till all these elements are in balance.
In balance. And how do you disbalance these elements, and how do you balance the elements?
Correct. The major reasons for disbalance is, first, the environment. So whenever it's too hot or too cold, it affects you,
mm-hmm.
you know. And secondly is when we take wrong food, you know. And thirdly, when our the lifestyle is different. Like if you're not sleeping properly, or if you're overworking. So that also affects your, you know, all the five elements.
This overworking is an everyday thing. Today, people, we all work too much. So actually, we should watch out for this. But if you do have to overwork, is there something to do to balance?
Of course. That's where Ayurveda comes into picture.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the first thing Ayurveda suggests, that ahara, then vihara, then aushadhi. Ahara means watch out your food habits. Vihara means your lifestyle. And then comes the medicine. Right?
Okay.
So if you are just being very cautious with the food, that first of all, you understand your body, because we all are having different, you know, we all are different. If you look at it, Ayurveda classifies three parts, all these five elements, called Vata, Pitta and Kapha. Vata signifies air and space element, Pitta signifies fire element, and Kapha signifies earth and water element.
Mm-hmm.
So each one of us has some element little more, some element little less.
Mm-hmm.
And we should just, if we just program our diet according to the food which suits the body, because everything does not suit everybody.
So in other words, you are saying that we should not all eat the same food, that we should watch out that certain foods we should not eat.
Absolutely. Mm. You know, if you look at it, some people are very slim. Some people are
like you,
medium built.
Like me.
Yeah, and some people are a little overweight.
Like her.
But the thing is, it's like you can't help it. It's your nature. And it's like I tell you, the quality of air is movement. So usually these people with more dominance of air, they are very fast and quick, and they don't gain weight. You can see their nerves because of the air element. And these people are very quick in learning things. Anything, like if there are 10 people sitting to eat food, some people will finish very fast.
Mm-hmm.
So this is because the air element is more in them.
Mm, that's me.
Yeah, we are mix of everything, but
yeah,
some little. And then Pitta is fire. They are like medium built,
mm-hmm.
Very good looking, of course, like you.
And then, Swamiji, I'm happy you realize.
Yeah. And they are medium built, and they are somebody who are like very dynamic, because fire signifies dynamism.
Mm-hmm.
They are the people who are good managers. They tend to get angry very often. They are
mm-hmm.
perfectionists,
mm-hmm.
you know. So they learn, like they take little time, but they are very dynamic.
So for the producers and the camera people, they have to learn that I go clean, order, be very good.
That signifies fire.
That's fire.
Uh-huh. And the Kapha is earth and water. So they are tend to be very, like, you know, they take everything very slowly, but very firmly.
Mm-hmm.
They take their own sweet time.
Mm-hmm.
And they eat little, but they grow, the weight grows. And you know, poor people, they are not eating that much, but everybody blame them. Why are you eating so
big
much?
Big eater, no, it's just a regular eater, it just sits there.
It's just that because the earth and water element is dominating in them.
Mm-hmm.
That's why if you look at it, some people can eat spicy food or oily food or fried food. Some people, their fire goes up, they start having headaches. Some people are easy to keep fasting to, you know, cleanse the body.
Tell me. For example, let's say somebody watching is kapha. Which foods should they avoid for a kapha?
You know, for the kapha, avoid cold food.
Cold foods, okay. Raw?
Raw is
not
still
so
okay.
Okay.
Raw is still okay.
Yeah.
Cold food is something which we must avoid.
They need warm.
Yeah, warm. And they should do more exercise and, you know, like jogging, running fast, which
okay.
allows them to sweat more.
Yoga.
Yoga is perfect for everybody.
Everyone.
Yeah, okay. But it's like more dynamic actions.
Okay, so for kapha people, run more, warm foods, do yoga, and be active.
Be active.
Okay. For Vata people, avoid?
Yeah, you know, Vata people, avoid raw food.
Raw food, salads.
Salad, uh-huh. Oh no, they can have salad with some oil or little warm, basically. Don't eat totally raw, just make it slightly warm.
Okay. Very yeah. good.
And it's good to have for them, they also should avoid cold.
Uh-huh.
Because cold immediately increases the air element.
Vata.
And the one of the side effects of air element is like body pains and mind running too fast.
And the joints?
Joints, yes.
Pain.
You know, all the pains is because of air element getting disturbed.
Mm.
Right.
The pains in the body come from the
air element.
Yes. Aha, very yeah. interesting.
So it's just that.
And what are the becoming foods for the Vata? Soups or?
Well, anything warm. Aha. Anything warm is very good for them. And eat in like frequent intervals.
Ah, frequent and not so, aha, not two portions per
two
day.
And
three
yeah.
or four portions per day.
Per day aha. and like little intervals because. The energy comes down very fast because they use so much of energy because air, they're like active, more active. So air get consumed. So they like, you know, have like frequent intervals food.
Very good.
Very more suitable.
Okay. And if you're fire, which things to avoid?
Well, fire, spicy.
Spicy, no good. Yeah.
Fried.
Yeah.
Yeah. And you can't afford to be empty stomach.
Oh, you have to have some food all the time.
Yeah, uh-huh. because it's like, otherwise it shoots up, the fire, because the fire shoots up and hits the head.
Fried like papas fritas, no good.
Well, in fact, I would say that you observe your body.
Uh-huh.
The body will tell you what is suiting you, what is not. So whatever you're eating, see how you feel after that. If like you're not behaving properly, if something is wrong, if the fire is too much,
the body tells you.
Then better to cut down on certain thing which is elevating it.
Where did you get all this knowledge from? Is this Ayurveda?
Ayurveda, as it says Veda, you know, they're like Veda means knowledge.
Mm-hmm.
And every knowledge, whatever right from like a small atom to the whole cosmos is present in Veda.
Mm-hmm.
So Ayurveda is knowledge about life.
Life.
How to have a healthy living. It's just that, you know, all these things keep happening to us on a daily basis. But if you know little bit about it, it makes us more healthy, more calm, more centered and more happy.
More stable. Es fascinante escuchar a Swamiji, Swami Paramtej, que nos está ofreciendo estos conocimientos sobre la salud. Y ahora en el próximo bloque vamos a hablar de los productos ayurvedas que se fabrican en la India y que se pueden consumir para mejorar la salud. Quédate con nosotros que volvemos en un minuto.
Un amigo estuvo algo así como un año diciéndome tenés que hacer el curso, tenés que hacer el curso, tenés que hacer el curso. Y yo le decía, ¡bum!
No entendía nada al principio, era como, estaban todos sentaditos, sin zapatos.
Explotó, increíble, impresionante, la gente, el cariño, el amor.
Estaba así como...
Que no hace falta estar mal para tomar el curso, sino que puedes estar mucho mejor.
Durante el curso experimentás como una avalancha de amor y de energía, y lo único que puedes hacer es demostrarlo con una gran sonrisa. Cuando crees en vos, empiezas a creer en todo y ves cómo todo florece.
Soy Claudia y hoy te traigo una nueva receta. Esta receta viene directamente de la India y se llama khichdi. Khichdi significa mezcla de dos granos. En este caso estamos usando arroz basmati y porotos moong. Lo que tiene el arroz basmati es que es muy fácil de digerir y los porotos moong tienen un montón de proteínas. Es una receta fácil y viene a ser una especie de guiso especial para el invierno. Te cuento, como ya sabrás o habrás escuchado, para la Ayurveda una buena digestión es sinónimo de salud. Lo que tiene este plato se usa cuando la gente allá está un poquito enferma porque es muy desintoxicante, es fácil de digerir y te da muchas proteínas y energía. Entonces prendimos el fuego, lo que vamos a hacer primero es saltear un poquito las especias. Aceite de girasol. Lo que estoy poniendo ahora son semillas de mostaza, semillas de comino. Esto si te gusta o si tenés, si no, no hace falta, pero le da este sabor, como te decía, de la India. Cuando las semillas de mostaza ya empezás a escuchar que hacen a explotar, hacen un pop, 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 ahí ya podemos poner. Acá tengo curry, cúrcuma. También, si te gusta, puedes agregar un poquito de pimienta. Esta es una especie de sofrito que le va a dar el sabor. Y después, listo, ya podemos agregar agua, los porotos y el arroz. Colocamos el arroz. Los porotos moong, yo en este caso los dejé en remojo toda la noche para que se hicieran más rápido. Eso es opcional. Y si no quieres usar porotos moong, también puedes usar lentejas. Si le quieres poner una zanahoria, una papa, también podés. Pero en la India generalmente lo usan así. Listo, lo dejas cocinar 30-45 minutos y tenés tu plato especial de la India. Entonces, nuestro khichdi ya está prácticamente listo. Si querés, podés dejarlo un ratito más para que se haga más con textura como un guiso y todo se apelmace un poquitito más. Y si no, así ya está listo para comer. Es ideal para los días de frío o esos que necesitas mucha energía. Ya tenés el khichdi, tu plato especial de la India. Que lo disfrutes.
Aquí estamos de nuevo en Vivir Evolucionando, trabajando para ti. Voluntarios alrededor del mundo, millones, somos más de 350 millones en el mundo. asistiendo en diferentes partes donde la fibra social ha sido dañada, donde ha habido un cataclismo, donde ha habido terremotos, problemas, donde están las empresas llenas de estrés, como grandes bancos, grandes telefónicas. Estamos en escuelas públicas, escuelas rurales, escuelas privadas. ¿Dónde y quién no necesita algo de ayuda? En el arte de vivir todos necesitamos, y entonces tenemos la suerte de continuar con Swami Paramtej, esta persona que se dedica a viajar por el mundo esparciendo los conocimientos de la Ayurveda. Y hoy le hemos invitado para que, aunque él no sea el que vende estos productos, pero sí que nos explique cuál es el beneficio de estos productos ayurvedas. Swamiji, I'm just saying that you're not a salesman and you are an expert in Ayurveda, traveling all over Latin America, explaining the benefits of Ayurveda in general. But because of these products coming from India, I'm sure you know more than we know. I know that I use these creams, but I don't know the benefit of, for example, the toothpaste. What is the benefit of somebody using toothpaste? What is it made of, and what is the difference, I would say, you know, this toothpaste with any regular toothpaste?
You know, if we look at it, that especially toothpaste, which is like they're entering into the whole system, you know, if and...
You eat it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's whether you know it or not, some portion is anyway going inside your
yes.
body. And if you're using chemicals
mm-hmm.
and, you know, say the most important thing in a paste is fluoride. And fluoride, initially they were like, you know, so much of benefit, but people find that it's really not helping the teeth in the long run. After the few years, the tooth start becoming sensitive.
Mm-hmm.
And I yet have to, you know, study more, but people say that it also affects the glands,
mm-hmm.
you know. So it's like we really have to look into it, what we are doing, whether, you know, the whole body is a big organism,
mm-hmm.
you know,
mm-hmm.
and
everything is connected with everything.
Connected. So whatever we are applying or using, it is body's absorbing it.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, it's like a known fact, if you start using chemicals, what it's going to do? It's going to come out in some or the other way.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what like illnesses are for. It's
so these are all chemical free.
You know, it's like, I won't say that, you know, this is harmless.
Harmless, totally harmless.
You know,
very
totally
good.
Harmless, natural products.
Very good.
And like, you know, something, say, suppose cloves, like the natural ingredient, which is very, very much supportive of mouth.
Clove.
Clove, you know, and like there's so many names which I don't know how to say in, you know.
Cinnamon.
Cinnamon, all those things which are really very beneficial.
Mm-hmm.
And the good thing is in India, they have done a lot of research over
mm-hmm.
it. And the world is becoming more and more aware.
Conscious.
They want to be healthy. And you see, it's not only prevention of illness, not only treatment of illness, also prevention of illnesses. Because there are so many herbs which are just a supplement to make it stronger. Say, suppose, like as we were talking about earlier about the three things, Vata, Pitta and Kapha. So if you know that, every time when weather changes, becomes cold, you have cold and cough. So when you know it's going to happen, so better have some prepared and have something like tulsi, like some herb, which makes immunity more stronger to handle that.
Tulsi in the medicine is called what? Is it just tulsi or?
Tulsi,
uh-huh,
yeah.
Uh-huh. Not amla,
I don't know the botanical name though.
No.
But it's tulsi like very famous. Like, you know,
yeah.
In India, like tulsi is like a household name.
Uh-huh.
Right? It's like household herb basically. People grow it in their backyard so that they can put in the tea or whatever they're
drinking.
A little
bit of tulsi.
Yeah, because like so life supporting.
Very
in fact,
good.
All these herbs are meant for like the garden. So you can grow it in the garden because it's for every day. Because every day we get these thing imbalances happening
mm-hmm.
because of some or the other reasons.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a good idea to know how to balance it.
To bring all the elements back into their places.
Correct. And the same with all the products which they are made. They're made very carefully, keeping in mind that all the products are natural and it's more life supporting.
Yeah, of course. I mean, I don't want to put any chemicals in my body anymore. So if I have a choice, I choose. I use this cream now for my body, and it's called Manteca de Cuerpo. It's delicioso. Absolutely tiene toda una suavidad. Al día siguiente, cuando te duchas, sientes la piel tan suave, se mantiene algún tipo, no sé qué ingredientes, porque es tan chiquitito que no lo puedo leer, pero hay una, esta medicina AMLA, yo sufro desde que era periodista, sufro de estos herpes de la boca que se llaman, de cuando sube el pita, sube el calor y se te pone un herpes en los labios, en la lengua. Y en el momento que yo no tomo esta vitamina C, siento el calor que viene a un labio, el virus que está latente. En cuanto tomo AMLA, el virus se mantiene a raya. Es maravilloso cómo afecta. Y ojalá que pronto podamos traer las medicinas del arte de vivir, que están fabricadas en todo, con todas las reglas de la ley, con todos los ISOs y con todos los productos. Todavía no, pero tenemos estos productos de belleza que no le digo a Swamiji que explique, porque él no usa seguramente la crema de noche, la crema de día. Yo sí las uso para estar fit. Y quiero que tú también escribas a la producción o que llames a la producción 4553-0407. Swamiji, I'm just giving tips to my lady watchers, saying that I'm sure you don't use morning cream, evening cream, night cream, body cream. I use all of them. So I'm very, very happy you were able to come. And if you don't mind, if you stay, we would like to have you in the program once again. And not to talk about Ayurveda, to talk about meditation and breath. Because many of our people, as we grow bigger, bigger, we have more people watching, and they would like to know from you what is the secret of breath and what are the secrets of meditation. Thank you, Swamiji, for coming.
It's such a pleasure to have in your divine company, because I know that you have been in meditation and spreading knowledge for so long. It's such a pleasure. Thank you very much.
Ayurveda has stood the test of time. In the last century, people did not care for Ayurveda so much because the whole focus was in allopathic medicine. People world over are taking to Ayurveda and they have realized the benefit of it. Ayurveda takes a holistic approach. It is to re-establish the health, not just converting one disease into another disease. We must all take Ayurveda back to our villages and to every nook and corner of the planet.